Hey guys, it's Becoming Violet. I just wanted to make a quick video, and I'm sorry for my appearance today. I'm starting to get sick here in my throat, and I just ate, so I'm like, alright. I just wanted to share these two products with you real quick. One is a product that a lot of people have heard of, and the second is a popular brand. You may or may not have heard of this specific product in this brand. First is the Shavite. I don't know how to pronounce it. S-E-C-H-E-V-I-T-E. I absolutely love this top coat. I raved about the 3-minute artificial nails that I got at Walmart. let me turn this down. I've got Demi Lovato's version of Let It Go playing in the background, and it just seems really loud to me, so I hope you can hear me talking up till this point. But the 3-minute artificial, as great as it is, and it is rather cheap, it's like between $4 and $5, this is awesome. It dries extremely fast. Put it on, and I swear within like 5 minutes, my nails are hard, they're dry enough to rummage through my purse. Of course, I've only used it on maybe 2 layers of polish. I don't know if it'll work with my nail art, but I love this. It is slightly more expensive. I would say I paid 8-something for this bottle if I were to buy it. Because I know at my Walmart it's like 8.50-something, but I had a friend give this to me, and it was awesome that she did that, because it really didn't want to spend that much on a top coat, but it's well worth it, and I definitely will when I run out. So I'm like holding on to this. I'm one of those people that like I keep all my best products like put away so no one else uses them. And then my second favorite thing this month is Sally Hansen's Advanced Cartisanal Strengthener. A lot of people use this, but I've noticed that it's really hard to find in stores, so I don't think a lot of people know about it unless they're really into doing their nails. And I keep going from looking at the camera to looking at the screen because... But I've been using this for... I started using it the day after July 4th. Yeah, it was July 5th when I started using it. It is now July 22nd, and my nails are extremely hard. Right now, all I have on my nails are some oil, and let's see, I want you to be able to, like, I don't know, you can't really see, they're thick, they're hard, I mean, they haven't chipped, they haven't cracked or anything. I was before this using Sally Hansen's regular hardest nails, and then I did like their Teflon Turf. Again, they're slightly more expensive, but for a nail hardener or strengthener, highly recommended. I stopped using hardeners because I noticed when I took it off, my nails were still really, really thin, really brittle. But even when I take this off, like I can go 2-3 days without using this, and my nails still have that strength. They still are strong, hard. I could probably go longer, but I just don't like doing that. I prefer keeping a treatment on my nails as much as I can. It just makes it easier. And I use this as my base coat, and now the Shavite as my top coat. And one thing that I will warn about this top coat is that a lot of people have said that when you get about halfway through, it starts to thicken and get streaky and kind of stringy. But there's a solution. You can just put a couple drops in it, pull it around, and it's good as new. So when it gets to that point, I will order it and see if that stuff works, and I'll do a review for you. That's about it. I'm sorry, my shirt keeps slipping. It's really loose. One thing I did want to say is I had a horrible salon experience. At I believe it's called Royal Nails or something, or it, it was inside of a Walmart, and she cut my nails after I told her not to. So my nails were a lot longer, and you can see they're still pretty long. They were a lot longer. They were a good, I'd say, 3-4 centimeters longer. So that's pretty long for nails. And I was reaching right at the 3-month mark of growing my nails, so that can give you an idea of how long they were. And I hadn't cut my nails or anything. I had just filed them to that point. And she cut them. She used a really rough grit nail file, and it almost tore one of my nails. I brought all my own stuff. Like, I brought my own base coat and top coat. I brought my own nail file. She refused to use my nail file, and I asked for someone else. Like, I asked the guy, and he was like, this is it. So I was like, whatever, just, and then I told her, I was like, well, can you use a fine grit, and she goes, okay, and she uses one that was, like, sandpaper on my nails, and I told her, I was like, I really don't like it, like, the sawing action, and she still did it, and I, needless to say, I did not pay for it, and I walked out of there, and it was horrible, and I will not be going back. On the bright side, the owner of the store was extremely nice. I've never had any issues with him. It's just this one lady, and she, I don't want to be one of those people who's like, oh, well, she didn't speak English, but she didn't. She, very little English, like, and I think it was because there was a language barrier, because I told her, I was like, I don't want to cut, and I had the gentleman sitting next to me translate, and maybe there was something lost in translation, I don't know, but, I mean, other than that, she was a nice person. She was a very nice person as far as how she spoke to me and stuff. She did get a little bit rude when I asked to use my own items, which I think any salon should let you do. I mean, if you're going to bring your own stuff, that should be good for them. They don't have to use their product. They don't have to waste money. Like, instead of using their polish or their top coat or their base coat, which costs them $5 a bottle, up to, you know, $18 or whatever, they should be happy that you want to use your own products, and it's safer because you're bringing in your items. Now, I understand if it's, like, a cleanliness thing, and they're like, well, we can't do this because if we use this, you know, it might mix, whatever, but I highly doubt that. It's just a slightly irritating, but that's my rant for the day. I'm going to go and film my second video real quick, and I will post this, and I hope to see you guys later. Bye!